I'm just recording another video, and I thought at the same time, let me just quickly record my Garnier BB Cream review. I actually have recorded a full review of me applying it for the first time onto my face, what my reactions were, but I wasn't really impressed with the way I did it, so I'm going to show you short little clips of that video, but this is going to be the main video when I'm going to be talking about what I liked, what I didn't like, and I hope that you enjoy it, so keep watching if you want to hear what I thought. So when I first applied this to my face, the first thing that I felt was that it was so sticky and so oily. It was really, really horrible. I wasn't expecting that from this product. They said it was light and it gave you a nice glow, but it was really suffocating and the glow turned into a horrible oily mess, which I really, really didn't like. The second thing that I noticed as soon as I applied it to my face was that it didn't give me the coverage that I was sort of expecting from a BB cream. This is the first time I'm using any BB cream, so I was sort of expecting a lot of things from it because I have read a lot of reviews and watched a lot of reviews of the original Korean BB cream, and a lot of ladies say, you know, it's better than foundation, it's better than anything you've ever tried. With this, I fortunately did not find it was really, really sticky on my face. It didn't give the coverage that I was really hoping for. Yes, it sort of gave me a natural finish to my face, but I was looking for a bit more coverage. My foundation definitely does a way better job than the BB cream, well, this specific one from Garnier. I wasn't really as upset because I only paid 79 Rand for this, so it wasn't really so much of a splurge. It was really hot and sticky. That feeling did go away about 20 minutes afterwards, but if you're going to use this as a base, you're going to have to wait, you're going to have to apply it and then wait 20 minutes before the oiliness goes away and then apply the rest of your makeup. And honestly, girls don't really have that kind of time. I've actually mixed this with one of my darker foundations. I couldn't really wear it on its own because it was too dark for my skin, so I've actually mixed this with that foundation, and I actually find that it's quite nice because the mixture of the foundation is quite, it has quite a nice coverage, and then this just lightens it up a bit. I still unfortunately get the oily feeling on my skin. I do not recommend this at all. Repeat, do not recommend this if you have oily skin. It is a nightmare. My final thoughts about it is that I won't buy it again. Unfortunately, I didn't like it. It wasn't what I was expecting. I don't really find myself enjoying this on my skin. Yes, it's moisturizing to a point, but there's a very fine line between moisturizing and oily, and this is, for me, it's definitely too oily. A lot of other beauty bloggers out there, I've read their reviews and they say they really love it. You know, it's part of their favorites that they do, and I don't find that I love this product. Unfortunately, it's really not for me. I'm more of a foundation person. I have a lot of acne scarring and pigmentation, so for me, I need something that's going to cover my skin a lot better than this BB cream does, which is more foundation. One of my favorite products ever is, I'm trying to think of the brand, it is Dream Matte Mousse, I think it's by Maybelline, I'm not too sure. That is my all-time favorite base, Dream Matte Mousse. It gives you such amazing coverage and such a really nice finish to your face. The only problem with that is that you'll have to get a color that's exact to your skin, because if you do just one shade off, you get that sort of masky look on your face. Don't let my comments scare you though. You can definitely go and buy this at Clicks for 79 Rand and try it yourself. It's exclusively to Clicks, so you can't find it at Dis-Chem or any of those places. So if you want to try it out, you can. Maybe you love it. It's all about personal preference. It's not my favorite. Let me know what you thought. Maybe you have sort of tips and tricks of how to apply it, that it's maybe a less sticky or oily on my face. I'd love to hear your comments. Thanks so much for watching my video, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.